So hard to love my mind, but not the way that I do love you. Well, holy moly, me oh my, you're the apple of my eye. God, I've never loved one like you. And oh my, you're my best friend. I scream into the nothingness. There ain't nothing that I need. Well, hot and heavy, pumpkin pie, chocolate candy, Jesus Christ. Ain't nothing please me more than you. Oh, let me come home. Home is wherever I'm with you. Oh, let me come home. Home is wherever I'm with you.
From the Lakota language,
which means all my relations and reflect a worldview of interconnectedness.
Halifax says, during prayers and meetings, people use this phrase when they wanted to speak and when they had finished speaking. Listeners repeated it back to them to affirm that they had been heard. I think this phrase is so beautiful because it's an expression of respect for others. It is saying, you are important to me and I acknowledge that. Thus, I will communicate that to you via this phrase. And that was what I wanted to do for my meditation experience. I wanted to make others feel respected, and I wanted to make myself feel respected.
Nothing new is sweeter than with you. And in the street we run a free, like it's only you and me. Jesus, you have something to see. Oh, let me go home.
As part of the experience, it was recommended to clean your living space. And I felt that when my room was clean, my heart felt light. It had a huge effect on my mood, and when my room was cluttered, I felt like my mind was cluttered.
Home, let me come home. Home is whenever I'm with you.
Through taking the time to pause, I began to listen to my thoughts, feelings, and environment.
You're still in bed at 10 and work begins at 8. You burn your breakfast so far, things are going great. Your mother warned you there be days like these.
I'm truly grateful for this experience, and I'll continue carrying it forward in both my personal and professional life.
When the rain starts to pour.